Man proposes, God disposes. The case having been concluded, I had no reason for staying in Pretoria. So I went back to Durban and began to make preparations for my return home. But Abdullah Sheikh was not the man to let me sail through without a send-off. He gave a farewell party in my honour at Sydenham. It was proposed to spend the whole day there. Whilst I was turning over the sheets of some of the newspapers, I chanced to see a paragraph in a corner of one of them under the caption Indian Franchise. It was with reference to the bill then before the House of Legislature, which sought to deprive the Indians of their right to elect members of the Natal Legislative Assembly. I was ignorant of the bill, and so were the rest of the guests who had assembled there. I inquired of Abdullah Sheikh about it. He said, what can we understand in these matters? We can only understand things that may affect our trade. As you know, all our trade in the Orange Free State has been swept away. We agitated about it, but in vain. We are, after all, lame men, being unlettered. We generally take in newspapers simply to ascertain the daily market rates, etc. What can we know of legislation? Our eyes and ears are the European attorneys here. But, said I, there are so many young Indians born and educated here. Do they not help you? They, exclaimed Abdullah Sheikh in despair, they never came to care to come to us. They never care to come to us. And to tell you the truth, we care less to recognize them. Being Christians, they are under the thumb of the white clergymen who in their turn are subject to the government. This opened my eyes. I felt that this class should be acclaimed as our own. Was this the meaning of Christianity? Did they cease to be Indians because they had become Christians? But I was on the point of returning home and hesitated to express that was passing through my mind in this matter. I simply said to Abdullah Sheikh, this bill, if it passes into law, will make our lot extremely difficult. It is the first nail into our coffin. It strikes at the root of our self-respect. It may, echoed Sheikh Abdullah. I will tell you the genesis of the franchise question. We knew nothing about it. But Mr. Escom, one of our best attorneys, whom you know, put the idea into our heads. It happened thus. He is a great fighter, and there being no love lost between him and the wharf engineer, he feared that the engineer might deprive him of his votes and defeat him at the election. So he acquainted us with our position, and at his instance we all registered ourselves as voters and voted for him. You will now see how the franchise has not for us the value that you attach to it. But we understand what you say. Well then, what is your advice? The other guests were listening to this conversation with attention. One of them said, shall I tell you what should be done? You cancel your passage by this boat, stay here a month longer, and we'll fight as you direct us. All others chimed in. Indeed, indeed, Abdullah Sheikh, you must detain Gandhi bhai. The Sheikh was a shrewd man. He said, I may not detain him now, or rather you have as much right as I to do so, but you are quite right. Let us all persuade him to stay on. But you should remember that he is a barrister. What about his fees? The mention of the fees pained me and I broke in. Abdullah Sheikh, fees are out of the question. There would be no fees for public work. I can stay, if at all, as a servant. And as you know, I am not acquainted with all these friends. But if you believe that they will cooperate, I am prepared to stay a month longer. There is one thing, however. Though you need not pay me anything, work for the nature we contemplate cannot be done without some funds to start with. Thus, we may have to send telegrams, we may have to print some literature, some touring may have to be done, the local attorneys may have to be consulted. And as I am ignorant of your laws, I may need some law books for reference. All this cannot be done without money. And it is clear that one man is not enough for this work. Many must come forward to help him. And a chorus of voices was heard. Allah is great and merciful. Money will come in. Men, there are as many as you may need. You please consent to stay and all will be well. The farewell party was thus turned into a working committee. I suggested finishing dinner, etc. quickly and getting back home. I worked out in my own mind an outline of the campaign. I ascertained the name of those who were on the list of voters and made up my mind to stay on for a month. Thus, God laid the foundations of my life in South Africa and sowed the seed of the fight for national self-respect.